Sorry, everybody, it's Mon here. Welcome to some Elden Ring. Now, I want to go and make a few announcements before we go ahead and get into this. I know that this is a game that possibly some of you guys want me to go and play with in competition with God of Ragnarok, but one, God of Ragnarok was a game I love a lot more. I wanted to go and let the hype build up and at the same time down for me to go ahead and play it because I got mixed case takes. The game might be too hard, might not be this, might not be that, like a lot of mixed case of different settings for the game. I never wanted to go ahead and let different opinions direct my form of mindset, but because of that feeling, the first time I played it, I didn't have the best case of experience, and me not having to feel fit, even though I did not get a full take of it, I did not fully play it. It was just me playing it at cousin's house, and me not having the best case of experience kind of put me off. But now, with the hype down, but still mildly up, and multiple scenes, mixed opinions, reviews, talks, and the fact that I finished God of Ragnarok, I full expressed my opinion about God of Ragnarok in a few different discussions, and now I'm proudly trying to go and play it now. I feel like I'm certified enough, at least in my mind and solemn within all of the understanding and all the inner case expression about things, to go and play it. By the time you guys have seen this, my first roundabout, but I've gotten a roundabout within that game. I understand the characters, I understand the lore for the most part, and I'm going through it, and I'm trying to be as open-minded, because as y'all know, I'm a proud lover of God of Ragnarok. This was the game of the year for me, and from God of Ragnarok. But I know that this game, Elden Ring, won game of the year. I applaud them, deserved it, we're saying since. I'm gonna full see this game is my game, but from my opinion right now, from playing it, I don't regret playing it, and I am having a mild take of enjoyable experiment with it. You know what I'm saying? I'm having a mild case of coolness with the game. I'm getting better, I'm feeling good for the most part, but it's not necessarily anything too better or too badder at the same time. It's just kind of, you know, whatever in the same sense. But I hope that you guys are having a great time seeing whatever will come after this when the time comes. And I hope you guys have enjoyed it within just your own play. And I respect anybody who's good at this game. And again, I don't mean experience. Even though in the sense of experience, I'm having a mixed case experience. But I'm having a mild good case of experiment with the game. You know what I'm saying? I'm feeling it. You know, I'm rocking with it. Besides all that jibber jabber, I love y'all. I appreciate you guys for supporting me and all that. I hope you guys enjoy the bangerness of the instance of the game that this game has in some of the cases. And of course, the rage. Y'all know a man can rage. It's hardcore sometimes. I hope you guys will enjoy. I love y'all. Peace out, Marmy. You
Draco. Two big 40s and a big ass Draco. Three more millions, leave your ass on my day go. Put up a phone, not a blueberry fango. One fuck move and we straight to source it. Two small bands just to take you out real quick. Three more hoes, pull up on fucking shit. That's how it goes, baby, no promising. I'm with my niggas, yeah. We some rock stars and I'm with my niggas, yeah.
The fallen leaves tell a story. The great Elden Ring was shattered. In our home, across the fall, the lands between. Now, Queen Marika the Eternal is nowhere to be found. And in the night of the Black Knives, Godwin the Golden was first to perish. Soon, Marika's offspring, demigods all, claimed the shards of the Elden Ring. The mad taint of their newfound strength triggered the shattering. A war from which no lord arose. A war leading to abandonment by the greater will. Oh, rise now, ye tarnished, ye dead who yet live. The call of long-lost grace speaks to us all. Horalu, chieftain of the Badlands, the ever-brilliant Gold Mask. Fear, the deathbed companion. The loathsome Dung-Eater. And Sir Gideon Othmir, the all-knowing. Would again bless a tarnished of no renown. Cross the fog to the lands between to stand before the Elden Ring. And become the Elden Lord.
Okay, a lot of shit. Kid is fated to be the chosen. Ironic. It's a real big body rolling, big body. Shield, sword. Cool, name. Okay. Jump attack. Okay, not bad. Shield. Nice. Okay. So I can parry deflect. Okay. Boom. Whoa. Wow. Alright. Over here it says dead person recipes. Tarnish a wizard's finger. What? Thou the path to be broken. So claim your places out in the Lord. I'm not even read it right. Path BP? Because it's something weird. Because if you sound like proper English in a foreign say, it'd be like thou path be broken. Something. Chapel of Anticipation. These messages are put here by players or by developers. There's random shit everywhere. But this game looks cool. Starting off. I'm around doing stuff. Let's go down this bridge. Around the circle. Big roll. Okay. Pretty cool though. Controls are good, camera's good, it moves with your character, so that's pretty cool. And that's the Elden Ring. The big ass golden green brownish tree. The graphics look pretty good, so obviously not as like the peak stage scale of like God of Ragnarok, but it looks pretty stellar, I'm not gonna lie. Pretty cool. Got a long journey. Whatever that may be. And this is Queen Merica, the queen of this world, the goddess. The eternal. Those death. First off, well done. Didn't expect weak foe. But the boss, I was correct. Grafted son. I've never seen some kids using words, so I'm sorry if I'm reading them wrong. Okay. Green bars like my stamina, I feel like. Okay. Interesting. Nigga, damn. Something good to equal out the range. Remember this, and I'm saying that gives me maximum form health or something. It's multi arms. What even is a fucking crab spider? Like, what is with this thing's body? Oh my god. Okay, I just died. This seemed like that was supposed to happen. Sheesh. My first time playing the Elden Ring to the biggest L 2023. You know, this game came out in 2022. Character's knocked out cold. Hope you all are having a great day. Horse. Is that a horse or a yak? That's a horse. Why do they have horns?
Don't worry, Torrent. Fortune is on his side. We found him here, after all. One of his kind is sure to seek the Elden Ring. Even if it does violate the Golden Order.
And tears about love. Okay. We're in this bat cave. Burp, shield. There's all these ghost spirits, like, of the dead people, or is, like, their place? Because they look like me, tarnished, which I guess is, like, the human race in this world. If only I had a ladder. Either the gemstone or like the power stone, like shit. Alright, well, let's get out of here. Let's see about what's up this before we go. The Cave of Knowledge. Jump down the hole ahead and you'll find the Cave of Knowledge. There you can learn more about the game controls and basic actions, as well as other tips that may be helpful during your adventures in the lands between. Okay. Don't sound bad. Talk to this ghost person. And all these, but yeah, those definitely players so you can see white shadows. Tarnish, take the plunge. What, why? Of learning and remembrance. Call the arts of war in your warrior's blood. Pulse the strength. But it's how it's gonna be a weapon because it gives us range and the save of damage. It's a very dope case of weapon. I love how my character's got death defying eyes. Like, why am I here? I've seen some shit. Like, shit. But, look, it might be interesting. Hair in this case. Cool. Regenerate. Just the brain cells here. It'll simulate a mind back in place because, of course, the world is and everything's going on. If you switch up your shields, if you fist, mega mega. Sword, halberd, like normal, cool stuff. Please, no fall damage. Nah! Okay, there's fall damage. Realistic. The game's unforgivingness was not a joke, it was an understatement. And that's health. And the blues for the blue stuff, which ingestions like my like, super move power shit. Sites of Grace. Resting at a Site of Grace will restore your HP, FP, and cleanse any status elements. It will also refill your sacred flask. However, most of the enemies you defeated will be revived. You can find Sites of Grace by going where light coverage is. Quote unquote, these explanations are required in the form of info items and can be accessed from the inventory at any time. Quote unquote. This is from my screen, far away, it kind of might seem like that, but more deadly, it's not. And I got a clear view of this stuff. Lock on, right toggle, okay. Come on. Camera stays pin focus on them. Without camera, pulling at them, you can actually be good able to kill them. Try fingers, butthole. Yeah, hey, y'all funny. Splice. And one more you kill them, you get currency. Guarding. Already seen this. Big block takes a little bit of my stamina. Makes sense. Dodging. Attack instantly. They kind of like delayed the moves to set up the things, which isn't a bad thing. This might be confusing in a full-fledged fight. I choose. Subway for Elden. Subway for Elden? Shoot, maybe go ahead and try to open them up. It's whirlwind. Scrape. Man, got a big. What is the name of them? Oh, shit. I can just rapier spear, motherfucker. And then with the sword, I get my eagle on. I get in the samurai shidogachi stance. And I'm marching on to splice. Nice. A knight of the great home. But what I was gonna full say was like, and they say if my fill of it and fighting him, he looks like the one gladiator in the form of the Wormilo with the big shield and the Zolaki case shield. But with the halberd, with having a spear like form of weapon, I can split him up and full penetrate, flip it, my form of halberd upwards or do anything, and it kind of just sharpen my edge against him a lot more. Because with the case of the actual spear weapon, we'll be able to penetrate. I saw that from a mile away. And be able to, you know, do shit like this. Scrape, spear, you know, multi-clack. Different capabilities and this full penetrate. Spread! Put through it, you know what I'm saying? Skills. So, like, for instance, this stampede. Stampede! The pushback on that is crazy, man. It's a banger ass weapon. It's some good ass weapons. I'd love to go ahead test the other builds, but most likely can't change that because you're already with your man like Tarnish. What happens? Whoa! Just put right through them, nigga. I murdered that man so bad, bro. I'm gonna go and hide. I was press R2. Nope. This is a big slash. They don't know it's coming, so it might help out. But no, stance breaking. Big heavy hitting. Top ropes and bam! So you break their stance or you stun lock them. You can't splinter for their body. Stakes of America. Upon dying, you'll be revived the last set of grace. Okay, gotcha. Oh, God, this really is blessing me. Bow to the old mother. I don't know what exactly said last out of grace, so correct me if I'm wrong, was reading this super fast, but in the case of a stake of America, which in the same sense is a simulation, would be cool, but what is with this green yellow piss wall? Soldier of Godric, who the fuck is that? Block with a little bit. Big damage. Alright. Parry. Damn! Bam! Fought it. Get fucked. Get fucked. Get absolutely fucked. Dominated, bro. What is these red blessings? I wasn't bleeding this hard. Barely even. What is this? Oh, you're showcasing during people fighting Toriel boss and your butt. It feels bad. Probably gonna be filmed like that later on. You know, I'm just a noob out here, man. You know, as a turn, it's only my first day out here. You know what I'm saying? I just got here like a week ago. You feel me? I'm gonna stop. It's only my first day out here. You know what I'm saying? That's funny to say that because I would tell a certain strength. Emote? Press start button. You do? Oh, gestures. Here's are your emotes. You could do a bow. Point forward. That's probably crap. Okay. That's cool. With co-op or doing anything else, you could just do that. That's pretty cool. Multi-tally. Okay. Get more line of different forms of different things. I don't know if it makes sense, but a lot of different forms of different things. Different sense. I don't know if that makes sense because I feel like I said it super fast. But I mainly meant in the same sense of like when you had these multi collage of different emotes that fit in different forms, you get multi case of them. And then from there, and then multi different in the sense of these, they work. And with the multiplayer having to feel like Minecraft because it's a super open world, you could be in lists with another player. I Okay, some of these are written by other players you put in different places. Developer or original player, y'all motherfuckers are funny. Hold up, I got someone calling me. I need to go take this call and be quiet for the rest of the video, most likely.
Oh, yes. Tarnished, are we? Come to the lands between for the Elden Ring, Of course you have. No shame in it. Unfortunately for you, however, you are maidenless. Without guidance, without the strength of runes, and without an invitation to the Round Table Hold, you are fated, it seems, to die in obscurity. Luckily for you, however, there is one shining ray of hope for even the maidenless. Me, Vare. Take care to listen. Are you familiar with grace? The golden light that gives life to you tarnished. You may also behold its golden rays, pointing in a particular direction at times. That is the guidance of grace, a path that a tarnished must travel. Indeed. Grace's guidance holds the answers. It will lead you tarnished to the path you are meant to follow, even if it leads you to your grave. Grace's guidance will reveal the path forward, most certainly. To Castle Stormvale, over on the cliff. The home of the decrepit demigod, Godric the Grafted. It's time you set off, I should think, to Castle Stormvale on the cliff, where Grace would guide you. If you seek the Elden Ring, maidenless as you are.
Tarnished. I can see it. And I can also see that you're not after my throat. Then why not purchase a little something? I am Kale, purveyor of fine goods. I am of a nomadic people, selling wares as I travel. The land has been tainted by madness since the shattering of the Elden Ring. It's only tarnished like yourself, who keep things from drying up entirely. Let's say you're a very welcome customer. Goodbye. Nice to do business.